President Marcos also vowed to complete ongoing infrastructure projects during his term. This after former President Rodrigo Duterte appealed to his successor to continue the projects that had been started. Marcos also praised his father's and Duterte's infrastructure programs during his inaugural address.
My father built more and better roads, produced more rice than all administrations before his. President Rodrigo Roa Duterte built more and better than all the administrations succeeding my father's. Following these giant steps, we will continue to build. I will complete on schedule the projects that have been started. I'm not interested in taking credit. I want to build on success that's already happening. We will be presenting the public with a comprehensive infrastructure plan. 6 years could be just about enough time.
Marcos also said the Philippines can find a way around its energy supply problems. He also hinted at his preference for renewable energy, even claiming he built the windmills in Ilocos Norte.
We have yet to see large-scale practical solutions to pollution, though some are beginning to emerge. But there are tried and proven new ways of mitigation. Blades have been turning over the sand dunes of Ilocos Norte, harnessing a power all around, but unseen, long before this day. I built them.
In an interview with ANC in 2010, Marcos also acknowledged the wind farm was a private commercial enterprise. The Bangi windmills were developed and constructed by the Northwind Power Development Corporation.
Philippine President Marcos's inaugural address found wanting of key issues by an international human rights group. Carlos Conde of Human Rights Watch says Marcos's speech may have looked good on the surface, but he notes it failed to touch on the very issues that hounded the dictatorship of the Marcos's father.
This might be, you know, ironic to expect of a president like Mr. Marcos for him to say some things about, you know, social justice, human rights, press freedom. But these are real issues in the Philippines. And these are issues, you know, the democratic ideals are real issues that we have been confronting since the ouster of his late father. And for him to leave out any mention of those, even just a short shrift, even just, you know, to acknowledge that these problems existed and persisted would have made a little difference.
President Marcos also vowing to reform the Philippines' education system. He emphasized the need to change the way some subjects are being taught to make Filipino students more globally competitive. This includes science subjects and vocational studies, but not history.
What we teach in our schools, the materials used must be rethought. I am not talking about history. I'm talking about the basics, the sciences, sharpening theoretical aptitude and imparting vocational skills, such as in the German example, alongside the national language with equal emphasis and facility in a global language, which we had and lost. Once we had an education system that prepared coming generations for more and better jobs, there is hope for a comeback. Vice President and soon-to-be Secretary of Education, Sara Duterte Carpio, will fit that mission to a T.
Chinese President Xi Jinping ready to work with the Philippines' new leader. In his congratulatory letter, Xi told Ferdinand Marcos Jr. that he is willing to work with him to continue writing a great chapter of China-Philippine relations. Chinese Vice President Wang Qishan, who represented Xi during Thursday's inauguration, also presented a four-point proposal to enhance bilateral ties. According to Chinese state media CCTV, Marcos told Wang that Beijing was Manila's most powerful partner and that his administration is willing to deepen the country's participation in China's Belt and Road Initiative. There was no mention of China's increased military activities in disputed waters, but Japanese Foreign Minister Yoshimasa Hayashi also met with Marcos said the Philippine leader agreed to cooperate with Tokyo to maintain and reinforce rules-based maritime order. Hayashi added Japan will support the Philippines' effort to enhance equipment of its Coast Guard.